I'll introduce me with that video, so that's great. So lots to be proud of with that video, and of course the 300 really exemplifies all of these attitudes. As Al mentioned, we knew we had a great product to start from, very good bones, if you will, great proportions, great stance on the road. So obviously we, hopefully you hear me okay, a little reverberation here. So very good vehicles to start from. So we really focused on the front end, as Al mentioned, trying to capture back some of that some of that bold character that the original 55 car had. Obviously influenced a little bit too by the Ghia concept cars of that era in the 50s. All of them, key thing in common is that bold presence that Al mentioned. So it really starts with the grille. As Al mentioned, about 33% bigger than the current 2011 vehicle. We also minimized the amount of chrome on the front end, so done in a more tasteful way. We enlarged the grille. We have the wing floating in the middle, similar to 200. Mesh texture as well to get that DNA tie to the 200. We've taken the amber reflex from the side of the headlamp and relocated them to the fender, to the wheel opening. Gives the headlamp really clean, very modern look. In the same way, in the lower texture, we've done a Mobius strip, again tied to the 200, that really unifies the lower graphic, the center opening with the fog lamps. We've done LED fog lamps as well, as you can see from down below there. And what that really does for us is the combination with the fog lamps, the LED DRL, and the projectors give us a very, very white light, which is a very appealing look. So obviously, also from a form vocabulary standpoint, we wanted to create a design that was a little more clean, a little more modern, very full shapes and forms, some hard edges that are very beautifully drawn. Again, tying that to the 200, but we didn't want to lose the discipline that this car has. It's a more formal look, more articulate. So in the rear of the car, I can explain that just a little bit. We've done a new tail lamp, which you see here. Full LED lamp with the stop function in the middle, all LEDs. Also the bright ring around the perimeter of the tail function. Gives it a very even glow. Again, tied to the 200. Obviously these cars are very different in personality. This is a little more formal, so you see more of the vertical look here. But obviously that DNA tie is still there to the 200. We've also done a surface of the tail lamp that extends off of the deck lid in a flush manner, flows to the outside with the character line. Gives the car a wider look, a little better stance on the road. Gives it just a very stable look. A lot of the bright work, as I mentioned, is more tastefully done than the 2011 car, more minimized, if you will. Very tailored ending to the bright work. Also, in particular in the side view, we also wanted to give the rear end of the car a little bit of a lift, taper the plan views a little bit to give it more of a tailored, more compact look. So we've lifted that up. We've also added a dark balance down below. Gives it a graphically a lighter look. And again, in keeping with the 200, we've integrated the rear reflex and also the bright tips in the exhaust there as well. And gone to more of a horizontal look versus the round tips that today's 300 has. So we obviously have three vehicles here. Andy's going to go into more detail in terms of the price class walks, but behind me we have the Platinum Series, which has a lot of platinum chrome accents. It's really the top of the line. We have a beautiful car in the middle as well, but one of the key aspects is the S model, which has done really well for us, which is the car on the end here. We have a new color for the S model as well, which is a tri-coat red, called Redline Red. Beautiful color, shows the forms very well. Obviously with the S model, we have a lot of black accents. So the grille is a gloss black finish. It's a unique grille texture, so it's a different design than what you see there. Most of you on that side of the crowd, you'll have to come over and look at it in more detail. But it has a more coarse texture, a little more aggressive. The wing shapes within are an abstraction of the Chrysler wing. Gives it a really cool look. Black chrome around the perimeter of the grille, both the upper and the lower. Black headlamps as well. On the side of the car, you can see the hyper-black wheels. Again, in contrast, you can see the bright wheels on these vehicles. Gloss black BLO as well around the perimeter. All of the details like the mirrors, the door handles, and the little piece on the rear fascia go to body color. And in particular, this model is the V8 version, which will have a unique side sill down below here, a little more aggressive, and also a unique spoiler on the back of the deck lid. This vehicle also has a black roof option as well. So a really nice package that gives the car a little more of a sinister, a little more edgy, a little more young at heart sort of look. So Andy will talk about that in a little more detail and a lot of the features that each one of these models have. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to Chris, and he can take you through the interior. Thank you.